Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today I'm going to show you how to capture a frame from a video in the Mac Photos app. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 900 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. Now sometimes you have a video in your photos library and you want to take a single frame from that and save that as a photo. This could happen because maybe you accidentally shot a video instead of a photo, or maybe you later went back to a video that you took and find that there's a really great frame in there that will make a nice photo. Now I've seen people describe a variety of different ways to take a frame from a video and convert it to a photo. But a lot of them are a little too convoluted or produce results that aren't great quality. So here's a relatively straightforward technique that you could do using the Photos app and a couple other things that come with your Mac. Now in the Photos app, I'm going to go to my videos under Media Types just so I can find a video. Let's go to this first video here. And let's say I'm going to grab a frame as a photo. There used to be a control here on the right side of the video playback controls that allowed you to export as a photo. But that's not there in the current version of the Photos app. So the way to do it now is to first take this video into an external editor. So you could be looking at the video like this or just have it selected in a list and then go to Image and then Edit With. And here you're going to find a variety of different apps that can edit video. If you had a photo selected, you would find apps here that could edit images. Now, no matter what you have installed, you're going to have QuickTime Player because QuickTime Player comes with your Mac. So I'm just going to use QuickTime Player here and this will open up this video in QuickTime Player. Now that we're in QuickTime Player, we could go to the frame that we want to capture. Once we're there and we've got it just right, and you can use the arrow keys to go frame by frame to get the perfect one, then you can go to Edit and Copy. And this will copy the frame of the video as an image into the clipboard. So now you can paste it where you want. In some cases, you may want to paste it directly into some app. Like for instance, in Mail, if you're composing a message and you just want to send this frame to somebody, you can use Command V to paste the image into the message you're composing. If you're in Pages and you have a document open, you can use Command V to paste the image directly into the document. Well, what if you want to save it as a file? Well, then you can do that by running an app that edits images like, for instance, Acorn, Pixelmator Pro, Affinity Photo, or Photoshop. Create a new document and paste it in there. But if you don't have any of those third-party apps, you could just use Preview that comes with your Mac. So I'm going to use Spotlight to launch Preview. And then Preview has a nice function, File, New from Clipboard, or just Command N, that creates a new document and puts the clipboard into the document immediately. So with one step, I've created a new document and that document has the image from the clipboard. Now I can save it, and when I do, I get to choose from a variety of formats. It'll remember your last one, so I can choose JPEG and put it up here near best as the best quality. I can name it what I want and save it where I want. I'll just save it to the desktop so you can see it appears here. Now if I want to bring this in my Photos library, all I need to do is drag and drop it into the Photos app and it will import it in. I'll find it as the new item added to my library. And at that point, assuming you're using the default option in Photos where everything is imported into the library, I can then throw away the original file. Now there is a way to shorten the process a bit by cutting out QuickTime Player. You can copy any frame you want from the video in the Photos app, but you need to know a trick to do it. So let's go into this video here and notice you can do Edit Copy. But what you're going to get is you're going to get the first frame of the video. For instance, notice how the flag looks here in the first frame. If I go to another frame where the flag looks different and I do Edit, Copy, and then I launch Preview and then do New from Clipboard, you could see it clearly copied the first frame, not the current frame. However, if you go to Edit and then you look at the video down here, you can move the playback around by clicking and dragging here. When you stop on a spot, you see Make Poster Frame. Click that and it will turn the current frame into the poster frame. And note that you have to hit the Done button for this to take effect. And then we can go back to the list. That's what we'll see as the poster frame, the frame that represents the entire video when you're simply looking at it here in a list or when you first go into it and you haven't started playing it yet. So you can see what it looks like here, but the first frame, if I move the playback head, is this. So now what happens is when I do edit copy, it won't copy the first frame. It'll copy the poster frame. In fact, the default poster frame was the first frame. So it's always copying the poster frame. It's just that now we've moved that poster frame to another spot in the video. So now when I go to preview and I create a new document from that, we get the new poster frame. So by setting the poster frame first, you can just edit copy in Photos and then go directly from Photos to Preview. And here I could save as a file and then import that file back into Photos. I think it's a pretty common thing to want to take a frame from a video and use that as a photo, especially now that iPhones take 4K video. The frames themselves actually look pretty decent as photos. So hopefully at some point Apple will add back a function in the Photos app to export the current frame from a video as a photo so we can do it in one quick step instead of having to use QuickTime Player and Preview to get there. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.